Hi everyone, my name is Nadia, and today I'm going to reveal top Russian secret how to make best Russian borscht on earth. There are a few rules to follow in order to successfully achieve the best taste and look when cooking Russian borscht. Yes, it must have not only the great taste, but the great look too.
Just like a good wine, it must have good, yummy, vibrant and clear semi-transparent colors. But if you do not follow these secret rules, you may end up with muddy looking borscht.
Like cheap, unpleasant looking wine. And yes, the taste won't be the best too. Let's begin. For cooking borscht, we will need the following ingredients. Meat. I got a beef meat and I prefer it with a bone because the bone will give you a good rich taste. When I cook the meat, I add dill seeds to the water. Dill seeds will add wonderful aroma and taste to our broth. Next, we will need potatoes. I have here 2 medium-sized potatoes, also 2 carrots. 1 medium-sized beet, 1 yellow onion. We'll also need green dill and parsley. At the end, I will add cabbage. We'll need 1 red bell pepper. Of course, salt, butter to make zazharka, which is a dressing to dress up our borscht, and tomatoes. Now all vegetables need to be washed, cut, sliced and diced.
First, we will cook bouillon or broth. For that, we will put our meat into the soup pot. Fill soup pot with cold water and heat it up till water starts boiling.
Now on top of the water, we have this spume or foam. And I will remove it as much as possible, because otherwise this spume would make our bouillon looking unpleasantly muddy. So we'll get rid of it. Now it's time to add dill seeds to the bouillon and cook it with a moderate boiling till beef is well cooked. It should take approximately 90 minutes. Our meat is ready. The bouillon looks nice and clear. And smells good too. Now I will put their potato and we'll cook it till potatoes are ready. While potato is cooking, we have time to prepare for borscht zazharka or dressing.
Zazharka is a dressing made of vegetables, gently fried in a pan with butter and vegetable oil in certain order.
When the butter melts, I'll start with onions that are cut into medium-sized pieces. I put lots of onions. The more onions, the better is the taste. And in general, the more zazharka, the better taste of the borscht. Onions should be fried. Moisture should come out of it, but do not overcook. I add a little bit of salt when I fry onions. Now onion is ready and we can add next vegetables. I will add carrots. Part of carrots I do fry and another part I put into broth. Same with beet. I'll put a little bit into broth and the rest to the pan. Now all this needs to be well mixed. And now we can add a little bit of vegetable oil here, then it cooks better, but not too much oil. Another important part of cooking borscht is frying vegetables well on moderate heat. Undercooked vegetables will not release enough flavor to our dressing. As a result, our borscht will not have great rich taste. Also, undercooked beets will not give rich red color. That is crucial for beautiful look of borscht. But we have to be careful not to overcook vegetables, because otherwise they will not be whippy and juicy, but rather feel like you are chewing piece of rubber or plastic. Good sign that vegetables are in right condition when on the bottom of a pan no moisture left, but only well-colored oil. Dressing is almost ready. Vegetables are still a little hardish, and now is a good time to add tomato. I rub tomato on a coarse grater. In this case, the skin is not rubbed through. This is very easy and quickly to do, and uniform mass of pulp and juice is extracted from tomato. And we got this beautiful tomato mass. We can add tomato to the dressing now and cook it till moisture evaporates and only boiling fat will remain in the pan, just like over here.
Okay, let's check how is our potato doing.
Perfect, looks very good. Not overcooked, still in shape and soft enough. At the end of cooking, we can add bay leaves, one or two, depends on size and your taste. And ground black pepper, also to your taste.
Please make a note. From the time I've put the beets into the broth, I do not cover soup pot with lid. That is crucial for the color of our borscht. If you will cover soup pot, then the beautiful red color from beet will fade.
There is an easy sign for checking if zasharka is ready. Look at the bubbles between vegetables and see if bubbles are watery or there is no water left. If there is no water left, but only boiling oil and it has reddish tint, then zasharka is ready.
Now it's time to put zasharka in our borscht.
I will add a little bit of bouillon to the frying pot and scrub everything what may have fried or stuck to the bottom. It's not because I'm greedy, but because this is the most delicious zasharka's part. And I'll put this into our borscht. Look at this beautiful red color. Such a delicious looking dish. And now finally I will add cabbage and red bell pepper. Right now borscht looks a little dense, but cabbage will shrink while cooking and everything will be just fine. And bell pepper. Now is a good time to check for salt. Not quite enough. I will add a little more. Turn heat to the max and wait till borscht starts boiling.
We'll wait till it starts boiling really good, but we will not boil it for long.
Now it's a perfect time to put in green herbs, parsley and dill. Once again, I want to emphasize that I do not cover the pan after I put zasharka and cabbage into the borscht. It is for the sake to preserve delicious red color. And also, some sort of cabbage may give a bittery taste when it covered with lid. Now, when borscht boiling well and everything slightly rises up, we have to turn off the stove. Even though we just added cabbage, our borscht is practically ready. Just a little bit more and that is enough. I'll turn it off.
Ta-da! We almost done, my friends!
Borscht is not ready yet to eat because the cabbage is still not cooked. You can see that cabbage still have white color and still pretty hard. We need to let borscht stay like that, hot and with no lid, for about 20 or 30 minutes. After that, our borscht will be completely cooked and ready to eat and enjoy. Cabbage will become soft, semi-transparent, but not slimy.
Once upon a time, there was a tavern.
Meanwhile, let's do a quick recap of most important rules. Number 1. Remove spume from bouillon. Number 2. More zazharka, meaning better borscht. Number 3. Keep the lid out when beet is cooking. And try to follow cooking rules and steps.
And here is our beautiful looking and fabulously delicious borscht.
A legendary popular dish between all Slavic people and countries and far beyond. Now, this is a big secret tip for borscht.
Borscht will become most delicious next day after being in fridge, when all the wonderful vegetable flavors will fully develop.
Also, it is best when served hot. Enjoy!
Let us know if you like what you have seen. We will make more videos of cooking recipes so you can explore new fun dishes and enjoy them. Also, if you are looking to buy kitchen tools, accessories, machines, we will appreciate if you will buy them from our affiliated links below in descriptions. It will not cost you a penny more, but will help us a little here, a little there. Thank you for watching, and we will see you in the next videos. Don't forget to subscribe. Bye-bye.